Pickup orders can be created in different ways, depending on your workflow. If your customers send you purchase orders, those orders can be converted into pickup orders, saving you time and data entry. Just click the Actions button in the document view or right-click the purchase order in the list. In the next part of this video, we'll go over the screens in the pickup order dialog box so you can see how to create one manually too. To create pickup orders manually, go to Warehousing, Pickup Orders. Click Add, and then a dialog box opens. All the details you enter here will fill into the document automatically. We'll start on the General tab. Include as much or as little as you need. Some fields are filled in already, such as the pickup order number, the dates, employee, and your company who is the one issuing the order. Set the times as needed. Next, go to the Shipper tab and select who is shipping the items and where to pick them up. If the addresses are the same, click the Copy button. The entities are pulled from your maintenance folder. You can add a company as needed. The Place field is connected to rates in zones you define, such as downtown or another area. Define the zones in the ports list. On the Consignee tab, select the person or the company who is receiving the goods ultimately. If you don't have this information now, leave it blank. If you do, click the drop-down menus as explained earlier. The delivery location is important. Select the person, company, or other entity where the items will be delivered. The Magaya pickup order can be used to go from any one place to another. The Client to Bill field is the entity that will pay for the charges. The system defaults to the ultimate consignee for this field. This is connected to the Charges tab, making it faster to create charges. We'll look at that when we get to the Charges tab. Next, let's go to the Supplier tab. The supplier is the entity who provides the goods for the shipper, or it may be the same as the shipper. Fill in the invoice and purchase order numbers as needed. If this pickup order was created by converting a purchase order, then this field would be filled in already. On the Carrier tab, select the Overland Trucking Company or other carrier. This pulls from your carrier list in the Maintenance folder where you can enter all the carriers you work with. This makes it easy to change to a different carrier to ensure your customers' items keep moving. If you will use the ExpressLink plugin, select UPS, FedEx, or USPS. Then you will not need to enter any charges on the Charges tab later because the plugin calculates them based on your contracted rates with the provider. The Preferred Mode of Transportation field is also connected to the rates you can set up in your system. The Preferred Mode of Transportation field will fill in if you received this pickup order request from a customer who created it in LiveTrack. As you can see, the software connects many fields to automate processes for you. As a 3PL, you may not use the main carrier field because it's for exporting items after the pickup is completed. Let's go to the Commodities tab, the place where you will add the items to be picked up. A commodity can be a part number that's already defined in your Magaya system, or it can be loose items that you add. You can define many types of items, including kits, items that are perishable, or have variable weights. There are a lot of functions on this tab, so let's discuss one at a time. To add a lone item, one that doesn't have any items inside it, click Add. When you add a commodity, a new dialog box opens. It has a lot of tabs, which gives you the flexibility to add as much information as you need. If you have a part number, select it, or enter the description and other details. If a customer sends you large cases that you will need to break down later to distribute the items inside the case, then you can define that as a nested or compound part number in your Magaya system. We'll get into details of managing compound part numbers in the 3PL video on receiving. To pick up a compound item, select the predefined part number. The Pieces field is how many packages will display on the line item in the Commodity tab. Even if you have one box with other pieces inside it, enter 1 in the Pieces field. If you use the Express Link plugin, each line must have only one piece per line. The Buy Totals field is volume and weight of all pieces together. This is useful if you don't know the weight of each box. The Quantity field is used to enter the quantity of items commercially purchased. This field is used if you are declaring insurance, or if you need a commercial invoice to include the value per item. This is used for resale items. It's optional. On the Identification tab, select a commodity type, save the serial number, add an expiration date, and more as needed. If the items are classified as hazardous, you can enter the details on the Hazardous tab. The other tabs are available, but not often used when picking up items. Click OK to save the information in the Commodity dialog box and return to the Commodity tab in the Pickup order. If an item has other items inside it, such as a pallet or a container, click the Add Container button. Enter as many details about the container as needed. The Refrigerated tab contains fields for the ventilation and temperature setup. Let's look at other buttons on the Commodity tab. To copy a commodity, right-click it. The Detail button is not active unless the item is a container with items inside it. Click it to open the dialog box for a container or package. Repacking is typically done in the warehouse after items are received, and they need to be repacked to be shipped out by grouping them inside another package type or a container, so we won't use it now. Charges entered in the Charges tab are integrated into the accounting system in Magaya and will appear on invoices, bills, etc. To add a charge, click the Add button and select a charge type. Remember the Client to Bill field on the Consignee tab? If you set that field on the Consignee tab, then that entity will automatically be filled into the Charges dialog box, making it easier to create charges. If you want to change the entity, select another entity from the drop-down list. Since the mode of transportation is ground for pickup orders, the income freight charge and the expense freight charge will be ground. For local deliveries, inland freight is often used. If you have rates set up in your Magaya system and automated to appear in pickup orders, they will appear on this tab. If you want the charges to list in a certain order, right-click to move them up or down, and then select Output Charges as displayed. Other options available when you right-click on a charge include the option to recalculate or regenerate charges if you make changes. Then click the Generate button again to update the AR and AP transactions if you already made them. If you use the Express Link plugin, don't enter any charges here. On the Events tab, you can add events. These can be configured to work with the Transaction Tracking plugin, which can send notifications to your customers when an event occurs. The POD tab is the place where your proof of delivery details and customer signature will appear when you use the Final Mile app for pickups or deliveries. We'll see how that works later in the video. The Attachments tab is used to add any photographs or documents to the pickup order. Add any notes for the customer or internal notes for the employees. Click OK to save. And notice all the details fill into the document for you. You can change the document template. For example, there's a template that doesn't display what you charge your customers. This is useful if you're a non-asset-based 3PL and you don't own trucks but use a third-party carrier company for pickups. Did you know you can query rates of carriers and give a quote to your customer before the pickup? See the video on quotations for details. If you use the Express Link plugin, click Actions, Express Link, and select the provider. Follow the prompts in the screens. See our knowledge base for detailed instructions. You can print or email the pickup order as needed. But before you print it, let's look at a faster way than paper, the Final Mile app. The Final Mile app runs on smartphones that delivery drivers use to collect delivery information and a customer's signature when delivering merchandise to the final consignee. Drivers can see the list of pickup and deliveries for the day, cargo descriptions, addresses, and maps. We have a video that shows how it works, so I'll focus on the part related to pickup orders here. To create a final mile task for a driver, click the Task button from the document view of the pickup order. In the Task dialog box, select the type Delivery POD. Enter the subject and due date. Notes and the reminder are optional. On their smartphones, the drivers see and select tasks to pick up items and collect signatures. After the pickup is completed, the updated details appear in your Magaya database on the POD tab and online in LiveTrack for the customer to see. We have a video on the Final Mile app. See this link. Your customers can also send you pickup order requests online in LiveTrack. They can even print labels for their items, so when they arrive at your warehouse, you just scan them to receive them quickly. You can then generate your invoices and bills from the pickup order if you want to. Let's take a look at the pickup order list before we close this video. In the list, there are many options. For example, click the Detail button, select a panel to view, and tap the arrow button on your keyboard to view details quickly. Many reports can be created in the pickup order list, such as by supplier. Then filter the report by date and more. The last thing in this video is a quick way to save the list view. Follow these three easy steps. First, choose the columns you want. Second, filter the list by preset date ranges or by using the standard or advanced filter to view the information you want. Third, save the view to use at any time you want. Check out the knowledge base for step-by-step articles you can print or email to help you use the software fully. Thank you.